Hi everyone, today I'm going to share with you how to save eggplant seeds. Now if you want some free seeds, which means free plants for next growing season, from an eggplant that you grew in your very own backyard, you want to watch this video. It's so quick and so easy, you're not going to believe it. Well, the eggplant I have growing right here is an absolutely gorgeous patio baby eggplant that's absolutely loaded down with eggplant. But this beauty here was the massive eggplant I harvested just a few weeks ago. You might have seen that video. And I also already used half of it for delicious eggplant bacon. So you definitely want to go back and catch those videos. But let's get into the seed saving. Well, thanks a lot for hanging out here with me in the garden today. I know your faces are smiling there on the other side of the computer, and that just really makes me feel good. Today, we're talking about seed saving. Now, when you're saving seeds from eggplant, or any of your garden veggies for that matter, you want to make sure you save seeds from plants that are open pollinated, not from hybrid plants. Now, open pollinated plants are simply plants that are pollinated by natural means, by the wind, by the insects, or even if you hand pollinate them, that's fine too, because then they will turn out true to type. So seeds from this Black Beauty eggplant, because Black Beauty is an open pollinated variety, when I plant them next year, it will look like another Black Beauty plant. When you plant seeds from a hybrid plant that you might purchase at the grocery store, you never know what you're gonna get. But it's so easy to do. Now, typically, you want to save seeds from a plant that is overripe or from a vegetable that is overripe, like this one is, it's kind of shriveled up, because the seeds will be more developed. But this one, this huge, massive eggplant, is a winner, and I want to try and get more huge massive eggplants, so I'm definitely going to save these seeds. So let me show you how easy it is. Now, if you've never saved eggplant seeds before, you're gonna wonder why you never did, because it's so easy. Just gonna scoop the seeds out from the middle of this eggplant. Scoop out the pulp, scoop out the seeds onto this plate here. And the reason why it's important to save seeds from top producers in your garden, like this massive eggplant, is because it has such good characteristics. And chances are, when I plant these seeds next year, they're going to produce another massive eggplant. So this has quite a bit of really nice looking seeds in it. I'm actually gonna just get in here and scoop the rest of them out on the plate. Now I've scooped out all the pulp from the bottom half of the eggplant, which is where all the seeds are located. Now what I want to do is separate the seeds from the eggplant. I mean, look at all these seeds. I'm envisioning a whole neighborhood with massive eggplants now, not just my own backyard. Well, it just takes a couple of minutes to just separate the seeds from the pulp. Super easy to do. When you save your own seeds, not only are you getting free seeds and free plants for next year, which is always exciting, but this eggplant grew in my very own backyard, so it's used to my climate, my growing conditions, and is well adapted to where I live. So most likely, these seeds are going to be very high-producing seeds for next year. Man, there are just a ton of these things in here. Crazy! When you're separating the seeds from the pulp, you want to break it apart and look inside every single little nook and cranny, because they do like to hide in there. Look at all those. Well, I've got the seeds separated from most of the pulp, and look at all those seeds. Now, are you guys ever in awe of the wonder and the potential of one tiny seed? I mean, look at this. One teeny tiny seed. And think about everything that can come from that. Generations upon generations of eggplants. I'm always just in awe. So anyway, we now need to rinse off the seeds and rinse off the rest of the small little particles of pulp. So don't be too concerned about getting every single particle of pulp out when you separate it with your hands there. I mean, that took me about 10 minutes. That's really worth it for all the eggplants that are gonna come from this batch of seeds. So I'm just scooping everything into a fine mesh strainer. You definitely want to use a fine mesh strainer, not one that has big holes, because then your seeds are just going to run right through and everything will be wasted. So we got them here in this fine mesh strainer. I've got my hose right here, and I'm just going to give them a good little rinse. just to kind of separate them a little bit more from the remaining pulp. You get all those little bits and pieces of pulp off. I can see a few seeds went flying, but we'll take care of that. So I'm going to pick out the rest of the pulp here. So I just have seeds left in my fine mesh strainer. Now I've got most of my remaining pulp out of my fine mesh strainer. I'm going to give that another little rinse just to separate the seeds from the remaining pulp just a little bit more. And don't be too concerned with getting every single little piece of pulp out there. I mean, the worst thing that can happen is you plant a little bit of pulp next year, and that's not all that bad. So now that I've got everything rinsed, I shake out my strainer, get as much water out as I can, dry off my plate here. And gosh, this is just so easy. Now I'm just going to scoop my seeds or dump my seeds out onto my plate. And I'm just gonna spread them apart as much as I can. And these are gonna go on a top shelf of a cabinet inside my kitchen where they won't get disturbed. And I'm gonna let them dry out for a couple of days. And when they're completely and totally dry with absolutely no moisture in them, I'm gonna store them in a plastic bag, label them, and we are all good to go for next year. Free seeds and a couple hundred free plants. How much easier can it get? Well, I thought it would be fun to come back to where I harvested this massive eggplant right here at the source, the massive eggplant plant itself. So I've made two recipes so far out of half, and I'm super excited. Although I scooped the pulp out to save the seeds, I still have a whole nother half to make more eggplant bacon, more baba ganoush, or maybe even some eggplant parmesan. So I hope you found this video helpful on how to save eggplant seeds. So comment below, let me know what types of seeds you're saving from your garden. And if you're gonna save any eggplant seeds, I'd really like to hear about it. Thanks a lot for watching. Make sure you share this video if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you don't miss when I post a video. All right, guys, thanks a lot for watching. We'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye. I have another eggplant growing under here. See this? Oh, there's two of them. Hopefully it's a massive one.